Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, and in this video we will discuss about elastic collision and inelastic collision. Elastic collision is defined as the collision in which kinetic energy of the system is conserved. It means that no kinetic energy is lost. When two balls collide with each other, the energy, kinetic energy after collision is same as before. But in case of inelastic collision, the kinetic energy is not conserved and it do not remain constant. For example, when two balls collide with each other, some of the kinetic energy is lost in the form of heat or in the form of sound or in the form of another distortion or another dissipation of heat. This is known as elastic collision and inelastic collision. Let us consider that elastic collision in one dimension. And we know that the ball M1 moves with velocity V1 and the ball M2 moves with the velocity V2, and after collision their velocity changes. The velocity of ball M1 becomes V1 prime and the velocity of ball M2 becomes V2 prime. And we also know the relationship of law of conservation of momentum, which states that total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. This is a law of conservation of momentum in which the momentum, total momentum before collision is equal to the total momentum after collision. And if we solve this by replacing the terminology of M1 in this side, M1 V1 minus M1 V1 prime is equal to M2 V2. This terminology will be same and this terminology will be replaced in this side, M2 V2. By taking common from this side, M1 is common, and we will take M1 into V1 minus V1 prime. In this case, M2 is common, V2 prime minus V2. This is, we can say that this is relationship A. And we are dealing with the case of elastic collision. In that collision, kinetic energy of the system is conserved, and we will say that the kinetic energy 1 over 2 mv m1 v1 square plus half 1 over 2 m2 v2 square. This is a kinetic energy before collision of two balls, and another case, 1 by 2 m1 v1 prime square plus 1 by 2 m2 v2 prime square. This kinetic energy after collision. So in this case of elastic collision, kinetic energy of the system before collision is equal to kinetic energy of the system after collision, and we can say that no kinetic energy is lost. Let us solve this by taking common 1 over 2 from this side and 1 over 2 from this side. We will see that 1 by 2 into m1 v1 square plus m2 v2 square is equal to, by taking common of 1 by 2 from this side, m1 v1 prime square plus 1 by 2 m2, sorry, in this terminology 1 by 2 is also common, m2 v2 prime square. So we can see that this 1 over 2 and this 1 over 2 can be cancelled out, because this is on both sides, we can cancel it, or there is another term, we can multiply by 2 on both sides, then this 2 will be cancelled out. And in the next step, we will write like m1 v1 square plus m2 v2 square is equal to m1 v1 prime square plus m2 v2 prime square. So we want to replace this terminology in this side, it will become m1 v1 square minus m1 v1 prime square. is equal to, and this terminology on this side, it will become m2 v2 prime square minus m2 v2 square. And we can see that in this side m1 is common and in this side m2 is common. We will take common m1, the other rest of the term will be v1 square minus v1 prime square, and in this side m2 is common, the rest of the term is v2 prime square minus v2 square. And we also know the relationship of a square minus b square. We know that in the mathematics a square minus b square is equal to a plus b and a minus b. So we will use this formula in this side and it will become m1 into v1 plus v1 prime into v1 minus v1 prime. This is the same formula we applied. This is the basic mathematical formula. And in this case, m2 into v2 prime minus plus v2 into v2 prime minus v2. And we can say that this is the equation B. The first equation was equation A and this equation is equation B. If we divide equation A by equation B, we can say that m1 into v1 plus v1 prime into v1 minus v1 prime is equal to m2 into v2 prime plus v2 into v2 prime minus v2. This is equation B and we will divide by equation A. The equation A was m1 into v1 minus v1 prime m2 into v2 prime minus v2. So m1 will be cancelled out by m1, this terminology will be cancelled out by this terminology, and m2 will be cancelled out with m2, and this term v2 prime minus v2 will be cancelled out, this one, and the final term will be v1 plus v1 prime is equal to v2 prime plus v2. And we know that this is a relationship, and from this relationship we can replace these terminologies after collision on the one side and this terminology before collision in one side. We will see that v1 minus v2 and v2 prime minus v1 prime. And if we want to replace or make a similar equations, v1 minus v2 is equal to minus of v1 prime minus v2 prime. This is also a relationship. We can say this is a relationship of C. We can name it. And in this equation, you can see that, or you can conclude that v1 minus v2 is the velocity. You can also write or say that this terminology is a relative velocity of ball 1 with respect to ball 2, is equal to relative velocity of ball 1 with respect to ball 2 after collision. And you know that this terminology is equal to this terminology in magnitude, but this negative sign will show the direction. And you can conclude that relative velocity of ball 1 with respect to ball 2 is before collision is equal to relative velocity of ball 1 with respect to ball 2 after collision is same, but in opposite direction. Now we want to find the velocity of the ball after collision. Velocity of any ball after collision. Let us consider that velocity of ball 1 after collision is v1 prime. Velocity of second ball after collision is v2, velocity of second ball before collision is v2, velocity of first ball before collision is v1. We will put this value v1 prime in this expression, then we will find out the velocity of a ball after collision, velocity of any ball after collision, and we will find and we will analyze that after collision how much kinetic energy is lost. Either the velocity is increases after collision or decreases after collision. So we will put this term in this expression, m1 into v1 minus this term v2 prime plus v2 minus v1 bracket close is equal to m2 v into v2 prime minus v2. We will solve this expression within the bracket, m1 into v1 minus v2 prime minus v2 plus v1 is equal to m2 into v2 prime minus v2. We will multiply m1 inside the expression or inside the bracket, m1 v1 minus m1 v2 prime minus m2 v2 plus m1 v1 is equal to, we will also multiply in the brackets, m2 into v2 prime minus m2 v2. So as you can see that m1 v1 and m1 v1, we can add it and it will become m1 v1 to m1 v1, and this terminology and this terminology will be added and it will become we will really replace in the second side is equal to m2 v2 prime and this one plus m1 v2 prime, and in this side we will replace this one and this one, minus m2 v2 plus this m1 v2 m1 v2 plus m2 v2. These are total 6 terms, 2 terms, 3, 4, 5, 6, and these are total 6 terms. And we will solve by taking common of v2 prime, because we want to find out the velocity of the ball after collision, and it will become m1 plus m2. And here we will take common to m1 v1 minus v2 is common m1 minus m2, and we will find out the value of v2 in the next step, which will be v2 prime is equal to v2 prime into m1 plus m2 is equal to 2m1 v1 minus v2 into m1 minus m2, and we will divide both sides by m1 plus m2 over m1 plus m2. It will cancel out and the final term will be v2 prime is equal to 2m1 v1 over m1 plus m2 minus v2 into m1 minus m2 over m1 plus m2. Guys, as you can see that this is the velocity of the ball, the velocity of second ball after collision. Similarly, we can also find out that velocity of first ball after collision, because we also know that mass m1, velocity m1 before collision, and mass of the ball m1 plus m2, and these cannot, mass of the ball cannot be changed before or after collision, only velocity can be changed. So we need to find out how much velocity we can get or how much velocity kinetic energy is lost. Similarly, we can find out the velocity of first ball of tripleon. Up till now we have finished the elastic collision in one dimension. If you like our video, you can comment or you can give us some suggestions how we can improve or how we can change the methodology. Up till now we have finished. If you like our video, you can subscribe our channel, and we will see you in next video. Thank you so much. Bye bye.